We are going to discuss the second topic of today, which I promised in social media, activating the sweets of the mind. Activating the sweets of the mind. As we can see everywhere, especially I personally experience in meditation classes, because I have been facilitating more than 10,000 people on meditation. The conclusion was very clear. The most important characteristic of suffering soul, they are being poisoned by the mind. Being poisoned. What I mean by being poisoned, they have a lot of inner critic. They have a lot of inner conflict. There are a lot of things to be blamed, from blaming government, blaming family, a lot of things to blame, include blaming themselves. That is what I mean by suffering soul keep poisoning themselves using negative and critical mind. In another word, the most important characteristic of suffering soul, they become the victim of the mind. They are not the master of the mind, but they are the victim of the mind. Shining soul, on the other hand, they are no longer being poisoned by the mind, but they are being brightened by the mind. So that's why what I mean by activating the sweets of the mind, grow from being poisoned by the mind into being brightened by the mind. That is what I'm going to share to you today. By the topic of activating the sweets of the mind, no longer being poisoned by the mind, but being brightened by the mind. You are no longer the victim of your mind, but now you are the master of your mind. Caroline Leaf, in her beautiful book, Your Mental Mess, is very clear in this case. Mind is not the brain. Brain is only one of the vehicle of the mind. Mind is energy filled both inside and outside of the body. Please do not identify the mind with the brain. Brain is only one vehicle of the mind. Caroline Leaf is very clear in her beautiful book, Your Mental Illness. Mind is the energy filled both inside and outside of the body. I myself have a unique definition about the mind. Mind is the dynamic interactions between intelligence, memory, and interaction. That is my definition about mind. Three aspects of the mind: intelligence, interactions, and memory. Let me explain my definitions about mind by using example. I live here in the village. In the village, most of the people are uneducated. They never live outside of their village. So that's why their intelligence is very limited. At the same time, the limited intelligence being poisoned by unhealthy interaction in social media. As a result, they will be visited by a lot of bad memory. So that's why there are many people who have mental illness in the village. On the one hand, they have a limited intelligence. On the other hand, they interact in the unhealthy environment like social media. What I'm going to share to you is the higher intelligence. What precisely meaning behind the higher intelligence? Go higher above any duality. Bad, good, sad, glad, pain, pleasure, right, wrong, false, true. That's duality. If you want to activate the sweets of the mind, please keep training yourself to grow above any kind of duality. the most important reason why suffering soul is being poisoned by the mind. So that's why they grow from one suffering to another suffering, because they are drawn in the duality. What I mean by the higher intelligence is keep training yourself to grow above any kind of duality like pain, pleasure, shame, and glad. How? Learn to be a witness. Whenever bad memory and good memory come, remember, you are no longer bad and good memory. You are now the witness. Whenever certain thoughts appear, like you think that you are wrong, the others is false. You are true, the others is false. That's kind of thought. Remember, you are not those thoughts. You are the witness. In sometimes certain emotion visit you, sad, glad, pain, pleasure. Remember, you are no longer those emotion. You are no longer those thought. You are no longer those memory. You are the witness. How to embody this simple but deep practice? The answer is on the three: practice, practice, and practice. Like learning how to ride bicycle. Only practice that perfect your soul journey. Practice, practice, practice. So that's why, thanks God, I spend my old age beautifully here in ashram. Keep meditating 24 hours a day. Enjoying my life mostly alone. Sometimes I grow together with my wife here. But the most important practice above all is to develop the higher intelligence. What I mean by the higher intelligence? Grow above any duality like wrong, right, false, true, pain, pleasure. You are no longer being pulled by pain, pleasure. You will feel deeply sad because of the pain. You will feel extremely joyful because of the pleasure. That is my meaning. You identify yourself with duality. What I mean by activating the switch of the mind, grow above any kind of duality. You are not those sad, glad. You are not false, true. You are the witness above the two. The idea is simple, but the practice is not simple. So that's why I give you certain steps just to open the gate that your practice can be easier in daily life. The first step that I'm suggesting to you in order to activate the switch of the mind is learning to forgive. So that's why certain books make conclusion. Forgiving is one of the important aspects of peace intelligence. Forgiving makes you harmonize between brain and the heart. Forgiving makes you release yourself from the dark energy of the past. A lot of benefit of forgiving. So that's why, in order to activate the switch of the mind, it is very important learning to forgive. One of the practical steps to learning to forgive, it is not the violence make the others harm you. It was deep suffering. Not only you who suffer, the one who make you suffer also suffer, even worse. Another approach, look at the people who harm you in the past as the younger versions of yourself. As we all know, in young age, include myself, we all committed a lot of mistakes. It is unfair if we can make mistakes, but we do not allow the others to make mistakes. It is unfair. That is the practical approach of forgiving. The first one, learn to forgive in order to activate the switch of the mind. The second one, train yourself to be holistic. Not narrow mind, but holistic mind. One of the beautiful analogy that I usually use when I explain holistic mind. We are all like three blind men who hold different part of elephant. The blind man who hold the body of the trunk, they think this is wall. The blind man who hold the leg keep thinking this is the tree. And another part of the elephant thinking that this is snake. What I mean by holistic mind, the question is not who is right, who is wrong. No, that is not the question. The question is what kind of animal in certain part is like snake, in certain part is like tree, certain part is like the wall. And combine those three ideas. That is what I mean by holistic mind. The third step after forgiving and holistic mind is develop a multi-perspective mind. If you are an economist, for example, don't see life only from the economics perspective. See also from the technological perspective, the perspective of law, the perspective of nature. That is multi-perspective. So that's why when I spend one of my beautiful year in Lancaster, small city in northern part of England, I read a lot of book in library. But one of the book that I still remember until now, the title of the book is Philosophy and the Mirror of Nature. The author is Richard Rorty. The conclusions of this beautiful book is very simple. The truth is like broken mirror. We all hold different parts of different parts of the broken mirror. Our most important task then is how to combine the different parts of the broken mirror. That is the practical step of activating the switch of the mind. Another analogy, like the light of electricity, which synthesizing the negative energy with positive energy. The same thing happened also with the inner light. If you are attached to the positive and neglect the negative, you cannot turn on the inner light. You can only turn on the inner light if you synthesize both the negative and the positive. One of the inspiring book in this case, the title of the book is Dopamine Nation, How to Find Balance in the World of Indulgence. Mental illness, according to the book of Dopamine Nation, mental illness recently happened because people only want happiness. They don't want any sadness. People only want pleasure. People only want praise, especially in social media. As a result, brain is extremely unbalanced. That is one of the important root of mental illness in our time. So that's why, in order to activate the switch of the mind, it is very important to learn from electricity. Learn to synthesize both the negative and positive energy inside. That is the beginning of the long journey of activating the switch of the mind. The key word is synthesis. Be a beautiful synthesis in the middle. What I said previously, be a witness. You are not those duality like pain and pleasure. You are not those duality like sad and glad. You are the witness in the middle. To make the story deeper, I want to make a conclusion in this topic of activating the switch of the mind by quoting my great master, the great Lama Padmasambhava. This message is very powerful when it comes to activating the switch of the mind. The beautiful message of the great Lama Padmasambhava is like this. Release samsara within itself until there is no spiritual attainment to be attained. Ultimately, samsara and nirvana are one. That's a beautiful message, you know. my interpretation, what is the meaning behind the message, release samsara within itself. As the natural natures of the fire which is hot, as the natural natures of the water which is wet, the same thing happened with those jealous people. No need to be angry to the jealous people. The natural natures of successful people like you will invite certain people to be jealous. No need to be angry. It is very natural as fire which is hot. No need to be jealous to your beautiful wife, especially because then it is the natural natures of beautiful face will attract certain men will come and fall in love. No need to be angry. It is very natural. It is natural as flower which is beautiful, which invite the coming of the butterfly. If you deeply understand this message, then the grip of duality will be loosening from one time to another time. As soon as the grip of duality loosening, one day your mind will be as wide as space. That is enlightenment. That is what I mean by the sweets of the mind. In the language of the great Lama Padmasambhava, release samsara within itself. Remember, nirvana and samsara are one. That is the conclusions about the beautiful topic of today, activating the sweets of the mind. Remember, grow above duality. Be the witness. Do not attach to the positive energy. No need to reject the negative energy. Learning from electricity, synthesize both negative and positive. How to synthesize negative and positive energy? Keep training yourself to be a witness in daily life. You are not those bad and good memory. You are the witness. You are no longer pain or pleasure. You are the witness. That is the conclusion. Anyway, thank you very much for keep listening my presentation. It's more than 1 hour. There's guided meditation in the middle. There are two topics. One before meditation, how do I heal myself from coronavirus? The second topic is activating the sweets of the mind. Thank you very much, beautiful heart, beautiful soul, light seeker, peace lift lover, the students on the path of meditation, wherever you are, deep thank you. Hopefully all beings are happy. Sabhisata bhavantu sukhitata. Shanti, shanti, shanti. Peace in the lower, peace in the middle, peace in the higher realm. Shanti, shanti, shanti.